Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2013. Okay, so it belongs to GATE CSC 2013. Okay, so the question is, consider a hard disk with 16 surfaces. Okay, so they clearly giving the numbers, so 0 to 15. And having 16 384 cylinders, so that is 0 to 16 383, and each cylinder contains 64 sectors, that is 0 to 63. Data store contains capacity in each sector is 512 bytes. Okay, data are organized in cylinder wise. Okay, a file size 42797 KB is stored in the disk, and starting location of it is 120. Okay, so they give the starting location, and what they are asking then, what is the cylinder number of the last sector of the file if the storage is a contiguous manner? Okay, so this is a clear type of array type of question, guys. So here they give the starting location, which is 1200, 9, 40. And they are asking, after storing 42797 KB of data after this. So I wrote it right. Yes. So after storing this, what will be the new location cylinder? They are asking, to be clear, right? Yes. So they don't want the list of the values. They just want the cylinder value, right? Yes. So for these type of questions, it will be really easy to solve them, guys. The only thing is you should have a clear idea, like what is the structure. So if you observe carefully, what is the first 1200 saying, guys? It is saying about the cylinder number, right? So cylinder comma, okay, so I think they did not give these names, right? Okay, so from these understandings only we can understand. So this 9 is nothing but the surface number, and 40 is nothing but the sector number. Okay, sector and surface, got it? Yes. So few students will be like, how exactly did I identify it? So to be clear, they did not give it with respect to names, but to be clear, what will have cylinder, guys? Cylinder will have surface number, and surface number will have sectors, right? Yes. So in that way you can identify, or with the values. So which value is around 1200? So this value not allows, not allow. So this will allow, this will not allow. So this is the cylinder. So similarly 9 will be allowed by both of them, and 40 will not be allowed by this. So indirectly 40 is this and 9 is this. So in that way also you can identify. So that's how I identified it. Okay. Yes. So let us continue. Okay. So how many cylinders are possible, guys? So they clearly give. So let me just copy them so that it will be clear for me. Okay. 16383. And similarly, surfaces are 0 to 15, sectors are 0 to 63. Okay, so now I want to store this much amount of data, and we are working with data, like with respect to the data, right? Yes. So first of all, let us convert this into bytes, guys. Okay, so at that time it will be a bit easy, right? Yes. So if I try to convert it, it is nothing but 42797 into 1024, right? So please don't multiply 1000, guys, because that will be approximating result, right? Yes. So now the result is a 43824128 bytes we want to store, right? Yes. I think I need to take some other color, so just give me a second. Yes, I've taken it. Okay. Yes. So now we got the result, right? Yes. So let us continue. So this is the how many bytes I want to store. Okay, and if you recall, each sector is having 512 bytes, right? Okay, so I think rather than calculating in this way, so if I divide this by 512, is it a normal result? Yes, it is a normal result. So basically, I need 8,594 sectors, guys. Okay, to store this amount of data, got it? Because one sector size is a 512 bytes. So with that reverse approach, I found that this many sectors for me will be enough, right? Yes. So let us continuously find in this way only. It will be, I think it will be easy, right? Yes. Okay, so how many sectors are there in one surface, guys? So there are total 64 sectors, right? Okay, so how many cylinders do I need then? So sorry, my bad. So it is nothing but 85594 divided by 64. Okay, so from here on it is going to decimal. Okay, it's okay. Anyway, there will be no issue. So we need 1337 cylinders. Okay, and we need how many lines. So basically this part you can neglect, but I want to calculate it exactly, guys, because for few students it could help, right? Because for few students who are thinking like how exactly we are going to solve these type of questions, it will be really helpful for them, right? Yes. So let us try to find this result. So for these kind of calculations, it will be, I'll be following this method, guys. So what you multiply 64. So remember that number and subtract 1337 from it. So you will end up with the rest of the point number. Okay. So you just multiply 64 with it. You will get the result. So this left out part is 26 numbers or 26 slots are left out, guys. Got it? Yes. Okay. Okay, so first let us find in this way and we will add this to this initial address. So at that time it will be easy for us, right? Yes. Okay. So how many cylinders does this occupy, guys? So it is nothing but 1337, right? Yes. And in each cylinder, I will take only 16 sectors. So it is divided by 16. So indirectly, I need 83. What are these, guys? These are nothing but cylinders, right? So I need 83 cylinders. Comma, so let me write down this value. So that is nothing but minus 83 into 16. So the result is 9. So here I need C. C, the cylinders are 9, and I need extra 9 of those. What are those, guys? Those are surfaces, comma 26 sectors. So this is my result. So I need to add this to my original value. So that is 1200, comma 9, comma 40. Okay. So now I can directly add it, right? Yes. So now let us start adding. So this will become 6 and this will become 6. Okay. So again, there is an issue. So if you observe here carefully, here we got 66, right? Okay. Okay. So here we got 66. Okay. I think we'll get 67 to be clear, right? Okay, or shall we add it directly? So just give me a second, guys. I have just a small confusion here. So basically these values will start from 0, right? Yes. So if I add them, I need to add one more number extra, right? Yes. Okay. So at that time, this will be 27 indirectly. This will be 10 indirectly. This will become 84 indirectly, right? So after removing that 0, like if we start from 1, right? Yes. So this will become 27. Okay. Okay. So if it is a 27 plus this, so it will become 67, but I can settle only 63 of them, right? 64 of them. So 67 minus 64 will be 3. So I will be resting up with 3 items here. Similarly, here how many items will be left, guys? So it is a 19. So here there is no issue. Okay. And what about here? It will be 1284. 19, 36, okay, 3. Okay. Yes. So at the end, the number of cylinder which we need is a 1284, guys. So with that understanding, I can say D is the correct answer, but I'm having a doubt that these two are wrong, guys. Okay. So I'm having that skeptical doubt. So let us try to redo it, guys. So basically let us try to remap them. Okay. So let us try. So it is nothing but 1284. Okay. So it will take lots of time, right? Okay. So just give me a second, guys. I'll be just checking whether did I do any mistake anywhere. Okay. Yes. Okay, so I think solving this question in this method is okay, but I was a bit confused, right? So when I was solving, so for these type of questions, I think this method will be really good, guys. So let us try how just to draw on the border so that let us solve the again the question, guys. So there's nothing to, it will not take that much time. Don't worry. So our current location, which they gave, is 1200, right? So let us find how many sectors are here. So it is nothing but 1200 into the previous value is 16. So 16 into 64 C plus 9 into this value, that is a 64 plus 40. So the last value. So basically how we will solve is this value is this, right? So if this is the cylinder, so each cylinder is having how many items, guys? These previous items. So basically as they fill, they will move one after the other, right? Yes. Like if you recall, we have already discussed one type of problem like this. So as sectors are filling, the cylinder will fill. As the cylinders are, sorry, just give me a second. As the sectors are filling, the surface will fill. As surfaces are filling, cylinder will fill. So as per this logic, I'm saying, right? Yes. So in that way, so basically the flow will be in that way. So that is the reason why we are backtracking it in this way. So that is nothing but 1200 into 16 into 64 is equals to, so it is a bit larger result. So let me write it in this way. 8800 plus I'll be writing it here only directly. 9 into 64. Sorry. So let me. So, sorry, it's not touch right. My bad. okay, plus 40, right? Yes. So the final total number of sectors here is 1229416. Okay. So this is the total number of sectors for this particular given address. Okay. So now we have already calculated this much data will take how many sectors, right? So these are the number of sectors. So for this, I can directly add that value, right, to get the original current location, current last location. So it is 85594. So the total number of sectors are 1315010, right? Yes. So these is the sector location which I want to find now. Okay. So now let us solve it using our traditional method. So that is nothing but 1315010. So each cylinder will have how much data, guys? Okay. So each cylinder will have 16 into 64, right? The data. Okay. So divided by 16 into 64. Okay. So the location is 1284. Comma, so this is the location of the cylinder. Okay, so with that you can directly say that option D is the correct answer. Even we got that only. Okay, so now I will be doing minus 128 into 16 into 64 or what. Okay, so let us do in that way only. Minus 1284 equal to, so we got the decimal part only, into, so let us into 16 into 64. So let me write it down in the brackets. Okay, so the decimal part is a 194, guys. So the rest of the parts are 194. So you can calculate in this way, or few students will be saying like, how did I calculate that? So it is indirectly 1284 into this part. So 16 into 64. So the result is this much, right? So this many slots have been occupied from this. So I can subtract it from that, this or this, that, anything will work, because you will be just getting the result in negative, that's it. So it is 194. So that's what I got, right? Got it?
Yes.
Okay, so 194 slots are there. 194 sectors are there, to be clear. So how many these guys will be there? So to find the surface number, so we can divide it by 64. So 194 divided by 64. So the result is a 3. So this is a 3. Okay. So now I will be doing minus 3 first of all, guys. So to get the decimal part, so into 64 I will be doing to get the original value. So 2. Okay, so if it is two slots, so 0th slot is a full and first slot is full, right? So this is nothing but 1. So this is the exact location. So it is 128, 3, 1. I have just checked it online also. So this is the correct result, guys. Okay, yes. And previously I did some silly mistake somewhere. I don't know exactly where I did also. Okay, yes. So that method will also work, but I prefer this method, guys, now. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. So the answer is 1284 only. So there's no issue with that answer. Got it? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching.
Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.